This is a watered-down version. And let me tell you something. I think we ought to go back to the first one and go all the way, which is what I wanted to do in the first place.
Okay, that was the wrong clip. That was Donald Trump talking about his Muslim ban. So let's talk about that.
Yeah.
Your thoughts on you know, how, where this is going. He's got two federal judges now, one in Hawaii and one in, as I recall, what, Massachusetts? No, Maryland, saying, no, this actually is a Muslim ban, literally. It fails the religious test in the Constitution. And
One thing that's not talked about here, Tom, and it's amazing to me, is if he's going to if he's going to succeed with these judges or taking a look at the, at what he's done here with these executive orders, it's going to succeed on the idea of standing. It's a very simple concept. It says, look, a Muslim living in Ethiopia or wherever they may be living does not have standing in the United States to say that they have been a victim of religious targeting. So that's where the argument begins. If you recall, even in the first go-round, there was I had questions about the standing issue that was never really tested. What ended up happening was Trump took it off the table, which I would have advised him to do, take it off the table, take another shot at it. But the standing issue is still out there. And you still have the issue that's going to, the issue at some point is going to converge, the question about police powers versus issues like, which are health, safety, and welfare, versus issues like religious rights, religious standing. Anytime those things can, anytime there's a conflict there, there has to be a question of which one of those things prevail. Most of the time, we're going to see police powers prevail. And you've noticed the way that this has been put forward by Trump is very clear. We're concerned about the safety of this country. Here's evidence that we're concerned. Here's what we've articulated in front of the court as being our real concern. And so at some point, somebody has to decide, are those arguments that are made by the government just, do they just completely fail? And if they don't, then somebody has to say, are they superior to the religious test? Has religion been tested here? And most of the time, you're even going to see police powers trump religious issues if you go back and look at historical data on these types of conflicts. So I don't think it's over at all. I think the Democrats are doing exactly what you would expect. They're going to the most favorable courts they can, and they're saying, gee, look, this federal judge said it was unconstitutional. But you, when you really take a close look at it, one thing that has really been under-discussed is this whole issue of standing. And if I were to call what an appellate court's going to do, the standing issue is something that the proponents of stopping this entire thing, they have to convince a court of, that there is adequate standing.
Yeah, that's fascinating. We'll see how that plays out.